The National Broadcasting Company invites you to listen to Glenn Miller's music.
Hello and welcome to Glenn Miller Music. I'm Barry Papernick. Nice to have you aboard for another edition. We've got a great program for you today. A little bit of Willie Schwartz reminiscing about the old days on the Chesterfield show. We've got some Dorothy Claire music in our spotlight and, of course, all the big band sounds of Glenn Miller and his orchestra. The big band sounds from 1938 to 1944. So if you're ready, here we go. Let's come out swinging.
Here's one that I'm sure is going to climb the ladder of popularity. I know it is. In the mood, Glenn. In the mood.
Thank you. Dartmouth College Undergraduates by Glenn Miller and the orchestra. Dartmouth's choice tune by Glenn and the band this week is that Harlem Riot, The 1 o'clock Jump. Listen to Glenn Miller's music. That's just what you've been doing. It's been the rhythm style by Glenn Miller, one of the nation's leading exponents of the swing trombone and one of America's ace arrangers. He and his orchestra coming to you from the Paradise Restaurant in New York City. The vocals were by Marion Hutton and Ray Eberle. This is the National Broadcasting Company.
Oh, boy, does it get any better than that? What a great set of jumping Glenn Miller music. Just heard the 1 o'clock jump. That was the tail end of a broadcast that was from New Year's Eve, 1938, from the Paradise Restaurant, as they said on the Great White Way in New York City. Before that, we were bouncing around Jersey style, little Jersey bounce from June 2nd of 1942. Before that, a version you may not be familiar, that's the original version, the original arrangement of In the Mood, a little different than the one Glenn recorded. That version was too long for a 78 record. It had to be 3.5 minutes, so there were some parts cut out. Of course, In the Mood became a big hit, but that was the version that the people were hearing at the Glen Island Casino on July 28, 1939. Glenn Miller debuting the song, which was one of his best. It was In the Mood. And we started out with a great arrangement from the Meadowbrook. Boy, there must have been some great music coming out of the Meadowbrook. That was Glenn and the Band with some Blue Skies from the 4th of April, 1939. And welcome aboard. We're swinging along with some Glenn Miller music right here. So nice to have you aboard. I'm Barry Papernick. Right now, time to go to the archives. Got a little soundbite here with Willie Schwartz, who for years played clarinet and saxophone with the Glenn Miller Band, telling us a little bit about the Chesterfield broadcast and the idea of where the medleys came from.
We enjoyed doing the radio shows because they were a little added income, and we were on three times a week for Chesterfield. And we did them wherever we happened to be, if we on the road. You know, in Washington, D.C., we did them at the Wardman Park Hotel, which was very nice. But then again, if we'd be in a little town in Iowa or Virginia, and there was no facility for doing the program, we did it wherever we could, in a school auditorium, or we even did it once in a boxcar in a railroad terminal, because there was no place to set up a band other than that railroad. He wanted to feature more music and less talking, so we got as much music as we could in 15-minute program, I think it was. And so instead of doing the full arrangement of each thing, that would have taken up the 15 minutes, so we just played a little bit of each song. That's why he had this medley he called Something Old and Something New and Something Borrowed and Something Blue. That was the theme of that radio program.
And here's a real oldie, My Gal Pal. Marion Hutton says you're a lucky guy.
You're a lucky guy when you consider the highest bidder can have the gleam in your eye. You're a lucky guy. Thank your lucky star. You've got a honey who wants no money. She'll take you just as you are. Thank your lucky star. Hey, fella, say, fella, don't you realize it's fated, you rated, open up your eyes. You're a lucky guy, you're just beginning, so have your inning and let your troubles go fry. No one can deny you're a lucky guy.
Something Borrowed, Al Kemp's popular theme song, When Summer Is Gone.
Something Blue, as if you didn't know, Wabash Blues. Thank you.
Yes, one of those great Glenn Miller medleys. In 3 minutes and 34 seconds, we heard My Gal Sal, You're a Lucky Guy, When Summer's Gone, and Wabash Blues. A medley is described by Willie Schwartz at the beginning of that number. That was from February 14th, a broadcast of February 14th, 1940. A notable date in the band's history because that was the debut of their new clarinetist. Ernie Caceres joined the band on that day, and that was his first broadcast. And I'm sure we'll feature Ernie in a future program, because not only did he play the clarinet and did it very well, he actually did some singing. So we'll do that on a future show. But right now on this show, in our spotlight, is Dorothy Claire, who sang with the band, and rather well, I might add, and in my opinion. She wasn't with the band a real long time. She had some employment issues with a former band leader, some legalities. We'll mention that in a minute. But she had some great songs with Glenn. And this is from her debut with the band. It's the Café Rouge, if you were there or listening on that date, January 11th, 1941. This is the debut of Dorothy Claire with the Glenn Miller Orchestra.
Not only is Glenn bringing you tonight some of his fine music, but he is offering you a surprise along with it. I think Glenn is the only one who could really tell you about it. Come in, Glenn.
Thank you very much, Al. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We have a little something special tonight. For the first time on the air with us, we're presenting a new vocalist. We're very proud of this young lady, and we feel ourselves fortunate to be able to present her to you on these programs. I think you'll enjoy hearing Dorothy Claire sing Swinging at the Seance.
Let's all give her a big hand. Come on, everybody. All right, Glenn, if you'll take that downbeat now, please. Swinging at the Seance.
Thank you. be a change in the weather and a change in the sea. From now on there'll be a change in me. My walk will be different, my talk and my name. Nothing about me's gonna be the same. I'm gonna change my way of living, and if that ain't enough, I'll even change the way I strut my stuff. Nobody loves you when you're old.
Dorothy Claire, all set to sing Sentimental Me for the soldiers down at Fort Knox, Kentucky.
Glenn, isn't that where our gold is buried?
Dorothy, that's where everybody's gold is buried. So start digging.
Solid.
There you have it, a couple songs from our featured vocalist in this program. It's Dorothy Claire, and we started off January 11th, 1941, a little swinging at the seance as she was introduced to the radio audience. We heard There'll Be Some Changes Made, that from January 30th, 1941, and we finished up with Sentimental Me, again from a broadcast February 5th, 1941. You know, Dorothy Claire wasn't with the band very long. And where did she come from and where did she go? Well, she came from the Bobby Byrne Orchestra to join Glenn Miller. And then Bobby said, you know, Glenn, she's got a contract with me. And it went back and forth a little bit. And after about 2 months, she did go back to the Bobby Byrne Orchestra. The funny thing with this story is when she was with Bobby, she was making about $75 a week. And published reports at the time say Glenn paid her $250 a week. Now, that was a lot of money in 1941. 1941, the average wage earner made $33.65. $33.65, and Dorothy Claire was making $250 a week. But the contract was a contract. Glenn said, okay, you can go back to Bobby. She did. And then Paula Kelly joined the Glenn Miller Band, and Paula was with the band for the duration of its civilian career. And that's a little bit of what's in the spotlight today. Dorothy Claire, we'd like every week to feature someone in our Glenn Miller spotlight. And this week, it was Dorothy Claire. You're listening to Glenn Miller Music. It is so nice to have you with us. We hope we're playing a couple of your favorite songs. Right now, one of my favorite parts of the program, we want to go over and see what's happening with the Army Air Force Band. And if I'm looking up there right, it looks like Glenn himself is at the microphone.
Starting off, we salute those rugged lads who have that dangerous rear guard spot in every fighter formation, the tail end Charlies. Medley time, and that means old, new, board, and blue tunes played for servicemen's ladies, be they Mom, Sis, or Mrs. Tooby. The old tune, Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair. Thank you. Sergeant Desmond, the crew chief, sing the new tune.
I couldn't sleep a wink last night because we had that silly fight.
I thought my heart would break the whole night through. I knew that you'd be sorry, and I'm sorry too.
I didn't have my favorite dream, the one in which I hold you tight.
I had to call you up this morning to see if everything was still all right.
Yes, I had to call you up this morning.
I couldn't sleep wink last night.
A little lend-lease from the Navy now as we borrow Chief Petty Officer Artie Shaw's Begin the Begin. Last the blue tune, Blue Rain.
Is a good one from the Army Air Force Band. The civilian band also played a version of that, but with a full band of the AAF. Boy, it sounded great. Swing Low, Sweet Chariot. The Glenn Miller Army Air Force Band. Before that, it was Medley Time, something old, new, borrowed, and blue. And Glenn himself started out with the introduction of the Tail End Charlie right here with some Glenn Miller music with Barry Papernick. Good to have you aboard. Right now, as we get towards the tail end of the program, as we always do, we like to go into the Chesterfield file and find something that was live. And here's a show the band did from the Wardman Park Hotel in Washington, D.C., April 11th, 1940. They're live, they're on the air, and Glenn himself started the program out just like this.
Good evening, everyone. This is Glenn Miller speaking with Marion Hutton, Ray Eberle, and all the boys ready and waiting to go. So why not make this your time to relax while we bring you Chesterfield's Moonlight Serenade?
That's right, Glenn. Let's all take time to relax and light up a Chesterfield. People call Chesterfield the smoker cigarette, they mean just this. Chesterfields give them what they want, pack after pack.
Chesterfield
Seems the cherry blossoms have gone to Marion Hutton's head, 'cause now she wants a hat with cherries.
Everyday smoker gets what he wants when he asks for Chesterfields. It's the one cigarette that has the qualities smokers like best. Thank you.
often mention Chesterfield's right combination of the world's best cigarette tobaccos. It's the smoker's cigarette. They satisfy. And Glenn, just as though I hadn't looked at the next page, I'm sort of in the mood for an old-timer.
Nothing to say about this next one. It's the St. Louis Blues.
Glenn Miller speaking. Now to now another week of our Moonlight Serenade. Next Tuesday, we'll be greeting you from the Taft Home in Cincinnati, Ohio. Until then, Marion, Ray, and all the boys join me in wishing you good night. In the meantime, keep this in mind. If you like our music, just make that next pack Chesterfield. Because everybody that smokes them likes them. Thank you.
here's good news for all you pipe smokers. From start to finish, Ranger pipe tobacco is made for pipes. Larry Bruss speaking. This is the Columbia Broadcasting System.
And there you have it, commercials and all. A Chesterfield broadcast from April the 11th, 1940, from Washington, D.C. And as you heard, the band was on its way to Cincinnati from there, doing a lot of those one-night stands. A great program. Hope you enjoyed that. We always try to put at least one of the live broadcasts into every program. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed hearing from Willie Schwartz, a little tidbit about the way things were and how they did their original broadcast. And our salute today to Dorothy Claire, who was a vocalist for the band, even for a short time. We like to feature one of the members of the band during every program. Hope you'll be with us the next time for more Glenn Miller music. Until then, I'm Barry Papernick, inviting you to have a moonlight serenade.
NBC has invited you to listen to Glenn Miller's music. Sweeter Swing is styled by the swing exponent of the trombone and one of America's ace arrangers, Glenn Miller. And until another time real soon, good night.